Hello students, today we are going to start a novel which is written by George Orwell. George Orwell, who was belonged to United Kingdom. And this novel, Animal Farm, is an allegoric novel. And this is the allegory on the Russian Revolution in 1917. And the character, the leading character of this is Snowball, and Snowball represents the Stalin. George Orwell, who was the author of this novel, belonged to United Kingdom, and the language of this novel is English. And this is a political satire, as I have told you. This is a political satire on Russia and Russian Revolution in 1917. In this novel, there are the characters. Most characters are animals, as pigs, horses, donkeys, and hens, ducks, etc. There was a farmer, manor farmer. And Mr. Jones, who was the owner of that farmer, was a very brutal, cruel personality and always busy in drinking and punishing to the animals. Then the animals decide to rebel against that man. And by capturing this animal farm, they changed the name of manor farm in Animal Farm. And then they overruled it and they generate it, they operate it, and all are done by the animals. And whole world was surprised that a farm was organized by animals. This novel was published in 17 August 1945 in England. Animal Farm is an allegorical and dystopian novel by George Orwell. Published in England on 17 August 1945, according to Orwell, the book reflects events leading up to the Russian Revolution of 1917, and then on into the Stalin era and the Soviet Union. Orwell, a democratic socialist, was a critic of Joseph Stalin and hostile to Moscow directed Stalinism, an attitude that was critically shaped by his experiences during the Spanish Civil War. Orwell, as we know, that he was a democratic person, and in this novel he condemned to the Stalin and his Stalinism. As we know, Stalin era in Russia and the revolution of Stalin in 1917, all are condemned by the poet, by the novelist George Orwell. The Soviet Union, he believed the Soviet Union had become a brutal dictatorship. As we know, in this novel, the Napoleon is a character, a big character, which established the dictatorship in this novel on an evil farm. And as we know, this dictatorship also was captured in Russia also. And he built upon a cult of personality and enforced by a reign of terror. In a letter to Yovana Dovet, Orwell described Animal Farm as a satirical tale. Satire on the society, satire on the politics, satire on the present time and contemporary time. This is the theme of the novel. It is a satirical tale against Stalin. Yuan Kante Sotriku Contri Stalin. This is the version, Russian version of that line. And in his essay, Why I Write, in 1946, he wrote that Animal Farm was the first book in which he had tried with full consciousness of what he was doing to fuse political purpose and artistic purpose into one whole. This is the main purpose of this novel. The original title was Animal Farm, a fairy tale. Fairy means the imagery characters are there in the, and there is no basement of the story, but there is a basement of this story is a revolution in Russia. So the writer or the publisher dropped a fairy story, the half title, the second title of this book, and in 1946 it was published with the name of Animal Farm only. Though the subtitle was dropped by US publishers for its 1946 publication, and subsequent all but one of all the translations during Orwell's lifetime omitted it. Other variations in the title include Animal Farm, a satire, and a contemporary satire. Orwell suggested the title Union des Républicains Socialistes Animales for the French translation, which abbreviation is URSA, and the Latin for bear, a symbol of Russia. Bear is a symbol of Russia because bear is found mostly found in the Russian part, and which recalled the French name of the Soviet Union. Union des Républicains Socialistes Soviétiques. This is the Russian translation of the title. Orwell wrote the book from November 1943 to February 1944. When the wartime alliance with the Soviet Union was at its height and Stalin was regarded highly by the British people and intelligentsia, and a circumstance that Orwell hated. Orwell always hated the Russian environment, and it was initially rejected by a number of British and American publishers because it is a very controversial matter, a political matter, and they don't want to take the risk. So all the British and American publishers denied to publish this book, including one of Orwell's own, Victor Galeon. Its publication was thus delayed, and though it became a great commercial success when it did finally appear, partly before the Cold War, so quickly followed World War II. It got a huge success at that time. So now we can say that the George Orwell wrote a satirical play, which is an allegorical novel, and this novel is dedicated to the Russian Revolution in 1917, and at that time the leaders are so humorous or so satirical that Orwell took the theme of that revolution in his novel. Time magazine chose the book as one of the 100 best English language novels from 1923 to 2005. In these 85 years or 90 years, it also featured at the number 31 on the Modern Library list of best 20th century novels. It got the 31st place in the English novels. It won a retrospective Hugo Award in 1996 and is also included in the Great Book of the Western World selection, and in most of the universities all around the world, it is taught vividly. And this book is a very satirical and very humorous in mood, so we can say this got a great commercial success also, and it gives too many messages to the society, to the political era, and to about the many other situations in society. Animal Farm begins with a very drunk Mr. Jones. Now the story starts with Mr. Jones, who was the owner of the manor farm, doing a really crummy job of, you know, his job. Luckily, there is a wise pig on the farm, and his name was Old Major. Old Major encourages the neglected animals to revel and run the farm themselves, and with one important qualification: everyone should be equal, then he dies. Only the line, everyone should be equal. This is the line which would become the quota line of the rebel and the rebellion. Old Major told them that it saw a strange dream, and in that dream he saw that all the animals have captured the farm, and the name of the farm will become the Animal Farm, and they run the farm, and there is no sign of man around the farm. So when he said about that everyone should be equal, this will become the motto of the rebel. This seemed like a grand idea to everyone except Benjamin, who was a donkey, a cynical donkey whose main job in life is to be well cynical. His job is cynical because he lives a long life. A donkey lives a long life, so he became the cynical and he became very practical. So Donkey don't like the idea about the rebel and rebellion. So they don't listen about the donkey and they rebel, and the pigs, being the smartest animal, naturally take the leadership. As we know, old Mister is also was also a pig, and all the pigs are seemed to smartest animal, so they took the leadership role. So much for that equality business, so much for old Major's vision or old Major's dream of a peaceful co-op too, because there is immediate conflict between two pigs. First is Napoleon and then second is Snowball. Snowball represents the Stalin. Napoleon represents the dictatorship in this novel. He dictated to the animal farm and he refused to listen all the rules which was told by the old Major, and he refused to do anything according to the old Major or according to other animals. He became dictator, so the Snowball rebel against him. And Napoleon wants to sit around and be in charge of everything. He wants to get charge of everything, while Snowball wants to teach the other animal and build a windmill. He wants to progress in his animal farm, in its animal farm. This shows a visionary idea of the character. Obviously, Snowball's plan is way better, so he wins. He wins the election and became the supreme of that area of that animal farm. Note, instead, Napoleon uses his private army of 9 furious and enormous dogs to become the all-powerful, dominant boss, leader, chief pig. Okay, he doesn't call it that, but you know it is a back of his mind somewhere. He wants to dictate all the animal farm. He wants to take the charge of the animal farm. So he make a 9 furious and enormous dog to become the all-powerful, dominant boss, leader, chief pig. With Snowball is out of the picture, and other pigs blame everything on him. They exploit the other animals shamelessly, breaking all the rules about equality that they had established over the rebellion. Life on the farm gets rougher and rougher. The conditions of the pigs became rougher and rougher. The animals forget old Major's original dream. They don't learn the reading and teaching. They learn only the following and following to the leader. The Napoleon make them only the animals of animal farm. The rules which was made earlier in the starting of the rebellion, now they are ignored by the pigs themselves. And the pigs make some poor management decision when dealing with the neighboring farms. The culminating miserable moment comes when the pigs send Boxer, a hard worker and a loyal horse who is ready for retirement, to his death, and they send him to the butcher house, and it was murdered. This is the pathetic condition in this. This is a very crucial moment in this novel. Boxer, who was the most vigorous personality in this novel, who was the most hard worker person in this novel, was sent to the butcher because it is no use to take him at the animal farm, because it is the time of retirement of it. In short, the pigs are starting to look a lot like the horrible human owner that we started with all the beginning of the whole mess. They start walking on the two feet, walking on two legs, and everything, in fact, they may even be rust. It looks like Grammy called everyone. We mean, Benjamin was right after all. He said there is no need to rebel or to rebellion against the men, because he saw the world from a long time. As we know that the dogs, the donkeys, lives a long life. And at last we find the Benjamin very right at his place. This is a very dramatic novel, and there are too many characters of as animals as the pigs, and pigs took the place of men at last. They drank like the men, they walked like the men, they danced like the men, everything like the men. They thought they are the smartest and they are the highest animal, so they have the right to do all these things which was done by the man in the start of the novel. Plot summary. Old Major, the old bear boar on the manor farm. Boar represents the big pig. Summons that animals on the farm together for a meeting, during which he refers to human as parasites. He said all the men and women are parasites on animals. They live without any work and the animals have to work for them. And teaches the animals a revolutionary song called Beast of England, Beast of England. When Major dies, two young pigs, Snowball and Napoleon, assume command and consider it is a duty to prepare for the rebellion. The animal revolt and drive the drunken and irresponsible farmer Mr. Jones from the farm, renaming it Animal Farm, which was called Manor Farm. Now it is Animal Farm. They adopt seven commandments of animalism, the most important of which is all animals are equal. This quote is given by Old Major, and this is taken by them when they start the rebellion and when they got the Animal Farm from Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones, who was a drunken master, and he lost his farmer, and the name of the farmer was the Manor Farmer. Now animals change the name of the farm and they select a name Animal Farm because they are the owner of that farmhouse from that day. And the most important seven commandments, one is the most important, is all animals are equal. This is a very humorous point because it was also changed. It will be also changed in the last of the novel. Snowball teaches the animals to read and write, while Napoleon educates young puppies on the principle of animalism. Food is plentiful and the farm runs smoothly in the starting of the novel. The pigs elevate themselves to positions of leadership and set aside special food items, ostensibly for their personal health. Napoleon and Snowball struggle for preeminence when Snowball announces his plans to build a windmill. Napoleon has its dogs chase Snowball away and subsequently declares himself leader of Animal Farm. He declares himself the dictator of the Animal Farm because there is no Snowball at all. And this is the last scene when we see the Snowball in the scene. Napoleon enacts changes to the governance structure of the farm, replace meeting with the committee and of pigs will run the farm. Through a young pig named Squealer, Napoleon claims credit for the windmill idea. He said that the Napoleon is the person who made the idea, Snowball is not. The animal work harder with the promise of easier lives and then the windmill. With the windmill, when the animals find that the windmill collapsed over a violent storm, Napoleon Squealer convinced the animal that Snowball is trying to sabotage their project. This is another blame on Snowball. There is a storm which destroyed the windmill, but Napoleon threw this blame on Snowball's shoulder. And he said that Snowball don't want to see the progress in Animal Farm, and he plotted against the Animal Farm. Once Snowball becomes a scapegoat, Napoleon began to purge the farm with his dogs, killing animals. He accused the consorting with his old rival. As we know, Napoleon uses only tricks and tricks on the animals. He said that some animals are going to be with Snowball, so he killed all of them, all his old rivals. Beast of England is replaced by the anthem glorifying Napoleon. Napoleon, Napoleon is our hero, who appeared to be adopting the lifestyle of a man. Now he wears a coat and pant and then shoes and walk like a man. All these are adopted by the animal. In a start, they said that the four legs animal is our friend and two legs animal is our enemy. But the pigs adopted the lifestyle of a man, and the animals remain convinced that they are better off than they were under Mr. Jones. They only thought that they are in a good condition because at the time of Mr. Jones, they could not find the food for one time. And now they got the food of two times. So this is the satisfaction for the animals. Mr. Frederick, one of the neighboring farmers, attacked the farm, using blasting powder to blow up the restored windmill. Though the animals win the battle, they do so at great cost, as many, including Boxer, the workhorse, are wounded despite his injuries. Boxer continues working harder and harder until he collapses while working on the windmill. Napoleon sends for a van to take Boxer to the veterinary surgeon, explaining that better care can be given there, and he sent him to the butcher. This is a very pathetic condition of Boxer. He was the most laborious personality in the animal farm, and he was the most vigorous also. Benjamin, the cynical donkey who could read as well as any pig, noticed then the vein belonged to the necker or butcher and attempts a futile rescue. Squealer reports that the vein was purchased by the hospital and the writing from the previous owner had not been repainted. But in reality, Napoleon had sold his most loyal and long-suffering worker for the money to buy himself whiskey. To buy whiskey, he sold to the boxer to a butcher. And this was the great loss of animal farm. But who cares? Snowball or Napoleon? Napoleon, never. Years passes, and the pigs start to resemble humans. As they walk upright, carry whips, and wear clothes, the seven commandments are abridged to a single phrase: all animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others. It shows the partiality of pigs. Napoleon holds a dinner party for the pigs and local farmers, with whom he celebrates a new alliance. He abolishes the practice of the revolutionary traditions and restores the name the manor farm. He destroys the name animal farm. As the animals look from pigs to human, they realize they can no longer distinguish between the two, the man and the pigs. These are some important characters from this novel. First of all, the old major in pigs. An aged prize middle white boar provides the inspiration that the fuel of rebellion in the book. He is an allegorical combination of Karl Marx, one of the characters of communism, and the Lenin, the communist leader of the Russian Revolution and the early Soviet nation. In that, he draws up the principle of the revolution. His skill began put on reverse public display, recalls Lenin, whose emblemed body was put on display. Napoleon, a large, rather fierce looking Berkshire boar, the only Berkshire on the farm, not much of a taller talker, but with a reputation for getting his own way, an allegory of Joseph Stalin. Napoleon is the main villain of Animal Farm. In the first French version of Animal Farm, Napoleon is called César, the French form of César, although another translation has him as Napoleon. Snowball, Napoleon's rival and original head of the farm after Jones' overthrow. He is mainly based on the Leo Tolstoy, Tolstoy, but also combines elements from Lenin also. Squealer, it is a very much learned pig, a small white fat poker who served as Napoleon's right daughter pig and minister of propaganda, holding a position similar to that of Motorov. Minimus, a poetic pig who write the second and the third national anthem of Animal Farm after the singing of Beast of England is banned. When this song is banned, he wrote another national anthems for the Animal Farm. Then the piglets, hinted to be the children of Napoleon, are the first generation of animals subjected to his idea of animal inequality, because they are given the special treatment the young pigs, four pigs who complain about Napoleon's takeover of the farm but are quickly silenced and later executed. Based on the great pairs of Gregory, Joao, Leo, Komnev, Nikolai, Brooklyn, and the Alexei Pauko. Prinke, a minor pig who is mentioned only once, he is the pig that tests Napoleon's food to make sure it is not poison. In response to rumors about an assassination attempt on Napoleon, now the humans, there are some characters of humans. First of all, Mr. Jones. The farmer, former owner of the farm, John is very heavy drinker. The animals revolt against him after he drinks so much that he does not feed or take care of them. So they rebel against Mr. Jones and get the manor farm and turn it in the animal farm. And there are three minor characters as humans: Mr. Frederick, who was the owner of the neighboring farmer, and Plington and the Wipers. These are some minor characters. Now the other animals, horses and donkeys. Boxer is a horse, a loyal, kind, dedicated, and hardworking and respectable cart horse, although quite navy and gullible. Boxer does a large share of the physical labor on the farm, adhering to the simplistic belief that the working harder will solve all the animal's problem. And he has been described as faithful as strong. And he believes any problem can be solved if he works harder. So he works harder and harder, but got a very tragic end at last, because Napoleon sold him to a butcher for the money for the whiskey. Molly, self-centered mayor, self-indulgent, and the vain young white mayor who quickly leaves for another farm after the revolution. She is only once mentioned again in a manner similar to those who left Russia after the fall of Tsar. Clover, a gentle, caring female horse who shows concerns especially for Boxer, who often pushes himself too hard, and she seemed to catch on the sly tricks and schemes set up by Napoleon's and Schuyler. Benjamin, a donkey, one of the oldest, wisest animal on the farm, and one of the few who can read properly. He is skeptical, is temperamental, and the cynical. His most frequently remark is, "Life will go on as it has always gone on, that is, badly." The academic Morris Dickinson has suggested there is a touch of Orwell himself in the creature's timeless skepticism, and indeed the friends call Orwell Donkey George. After his grumbling donkey Benjamin, in animal. Other animals, Mariel, a wise old goat who is friend with all the animals on the farm. She, like Benjamin and Snowbell, is one of the few animals on the farm who can read. The puppies and the Moses. These are the characters. And now the sheep. The so limited understanding of the animalism and the politician atmosphere of the farm, yet nonetheless the blindly support Napoleon ideas and the vocal jingles during the speeches and the meetings with Snowbell, because sheep are called the follower only. They never could be the leader. The hens are among the first to rebel against Napoleon, then the cows and cat. These are the minor characters of this novel. So we can say this is a very great novel written by George Orwell. It is a political satire and it is an allegory on the Russian revolt, which took place in 1917. And George Orwell got a great commercial success after the publication of this novel. This novel got a great success in literary career, literary society, and most of universities it is taught in these days. So it is a good enough for today. Thanks. Have a good day.